This is Marissa Lenti, and you are about to watch a Dice Junkies gameplay video.
This is BloodX, and welcome to another Dice Junkies gameplay video. As always, we hope you enjoy. All right, this is BloodX and Q coming at you. We are about to start Grounded 1.0. As always, I'll be Pete, and Q will be who?
Maxwell Small.
All right, this is BloodX coming at you, and we have found another skeleton. I have not gotten anything yet, but I just want to show you where it's at first, and then we'll go explore it together. So as you can see, I'm up here in the upper yard, just west of the Christy Doll car. There is a cap, which looks like it's a cap for the milk molar bottle, which there's one that has like four or five milk molars that I have been unable to get into yet. But anyway, so once you get underneath this cap, you'll have to cut some vines, and inside of here there is a old lean-to, which is unoperational, but then there is a skeleton. So let's go ahead and rummage and see what we find. All right, we're going to get Loyal Subjects Journal. We'll go ahead and take that. And there is a intern badge. Oh, it's the intern. Cool. Ooh, bonus hauling strength but minus movement speed. Wow, how much more shit can I build with extra hauling strength? You know what? I might actually use that on a regular basis when it comes to actually building structures and stuff. Anything else in here? Nope. Oh my god! Oh, okay guys, I'm sorry. I was wrong. There is 5 milk molars at the end of the tunnel. So after you acquire the intern badge, make sure to follow it all the way through and grab yourself a half a dozen, almost, milk molars. Power yourselves up. Hopefully you'll prosper and enjoy Grounded. Definitely leave us some comments. Q found it. Yeah, I'm on the phone with him. He's not in the party right now, even though I'm playing the game with him. He's a slacker. But yeah, no, definitely leave us some comments. We're finding some stuff and we're getting it out to you first. So definitely appreciate you guys watching our channel. Alright, so we are now going to go over the abilities that you get when you use the intern badge. It says we have additional hauling strength, but we also have negative movement speed. And when we go over to the status, movement speed is run slower. Okay, that's not very helpful. But neither is the haul more items. So I decided to go ahead and put it on and see what the difference is with the different sets of armor. Red and armor, which we can usually carry 8 items, versus the regular armors only carry 5. So when I put it on the red and armor along with the intern badge, I can now carry 18 items. So we have a significant increase of plus 10, and when we switch out the armor sets, you can still carry 15 with this. So it looks like it gives you an additional 10 carrying capacity on top of what you already can carry. So you don't have to carry red and armor to build anymore. I mean, 15 is quite a bit, but if you're going to be doing extensive building, then having those 3 extra planks or wood stems, it's not a bad thing. But as you can see, I am running with sprint on, and my movement speed is significantly hindered, even though I'm running natural explorer. So I think it has a lot of value when it comes to doing constructions, especially big ones. I'll let you decide. Let me know in the comments what you think about these badges, and have you found any that we haven't found here on Dice Junkies? Thank you for watching the video. We hope you found the content helpful. If you did so, please hit the thumbs up as it helps spread the channel for other viewers. As always, you can watch Dice Junkies live on Twitch at 3:30 Central Standard Time on Sundays.
We also stream gaming content on Twitch throughout the week, so be sure to subscribe there as well. If you can, please go ahead, like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you're up to date on all the Dice Junkies content. As always, thank you for watching. Hope you enjoy. They fucked my tomatoes up!